Hello, my name is Max Germer and I'm a team member of the radar department at Magna. I'm responsible for simulation topics and we are using CarMaker for over 2 years now. In our presentation, we will show you how we are using CarMaker to simulate our radar and how our cooperation with IPG has improved the radar raw signal interface. Our topic is the radar simulation with CarMaker 9. I will give you an overview about how we are using CarMaker to validate our radar software components during the development process. This is our agenda for this presentation. I will start with a short introduction of our automotive radar. Afterwards, I will explain why a simulation is necessary and how IPG improved the radar simulation in CarMaker over the past years. Furthermore, I will present more details about how we cooperated with IPG to bring the radar simulation in CarMaker 9 to the next level. This will be followed by showing our pipeline and how CarMaker is integrated in our daily development process. In the end, some use cases will be demonstrated. First of all, I will give you a short overview of our radar device, which is called Icon Radar. It provides horizontal and vertical detection with the ability to discriminate adjacent targets in a distance of more than 300 meters. The advantages of our radar are, for example, an object separation down to 10 centimeters, the possibility to replace a front radar by corner radars, and an ultra-high resolution point cloud imaging capability, which is comparable to LiDARs with 3D detections and velocity measurements. The radar provides object detection and classification, which can be used for advanced driver assistance systems like autonomous emergency braking or adaptive cruise control. CarMaker was providing simulations during the development process of our Icon radar. Virtual validation is more than just an element of the requirements. It also raises the development process on a new level. Nowadays, all the test cases that are defined in the requirements have to be passed in real tests and in simulations. Not only the functionality of features like AEB or ACC have to be proven, more or less the complete pipeline will be tested virtually as well. These simulations can support the developers during the entire development process from concept phase to SOP. Comparing the results of software components with ground truth data from the simulation is already possible in the early stages of development. Creating huge amount of test cases and re-evaluating the newest releases in a short time period is a big advantage of a simulation environment. The amount of expensive and time-consuming measurements with test cars can be reduced drastically. And CarMaker is a big support for that purpose. I guess all of you are familiar with the simulation environment of CarMaker. I want to focus only on the radar simulation in this presentation. It was continuously improved in the last years. I will show how the simulation changed from an object-based simulation to receiving complex amplitudes of all virtual receivers of a radar. Before CarMaker 7, there was only a radar sensor that delivered objects in a radar context. Basically, it was a probabilistic model that considered occlusion effects, antenna gains, propagation losses, radar cross-sections of targets, and noise. This model could be used to evaluate advanced driver assistance systems like ACC or AEB. All software components that are necessary for these features but depend on more low-level data could not be tested at all with this approach. For example, the clustering of radar points and object detection is excluded from the virtual validation in that case. By IPG introduced in CarMaker 7 the radar raw signal interface. This model provides detection points instead of traffic objects, like in the picture. These points are generated by a ray tracing, which takes effects like different materials, multipath propagation,
and Doppler shift into account. At that point, we started working with CarMaker. We are using the C-Code API to integrate our own functionality. Our sensor model ensures similarity between real and virtual data. But some problems could not be solved, while we get in touch with the developers on IPG side to further improve the radar simulation in CarMaker 9. In that release, the ray tracing was extended by an optical approach, which represents the behavior of an electromagnetic wave much better. Furthermore, these reflection points were not reported directly as detections anymore. They were put into a discretized range Doppler map that was used as a starting point for post-processing steps like filtering and peak finding. The new model provided detection points for the complex amplitudes of all virtual receivers as an output. These two modes will be presented on the next slide. As I have told you before, IPG and Magna started a cooperation project to improve the radar simulation for the CarMaker Release 9. All pictures on this slide are coming from the open house presentation of IPG. The picture in the left corner illustrates the geometrical and optical ray tracing. The dashed white lines are the new part and guarantee that from all not occluded interaction points, a reflection is registered by the radar. The other pictures show the two output modes of the improved raw signal interface. On the left side, you can see the detections in the range Doppler angle cube. On the right side, the vectors of complex amplitudes are visible. For both cubes, the origin is always the range Doppler map, where a filtering and peak finding is applied. For the detection output, an angle filtering and peak finding is done as well. All of that can be parameterized by the user. We are using the VRX mode for our purposes, because we can implement our own beamforming in that case. This beamforming is the same as the one that is running in the real radar. To validate the new radar raw signal interface, IPG and Magna also did a measurement campaign. In this measurement campaign, we performed a lot of different test cases and variations. We analyzed power levels, scattering, interference effects, and more. One example is shown in the pictures. Here we tested multipath effects caused by a guardrail. You can see the ghost target in the measured and simulated data. The complexity of the test cases varied from single corner reflectors or traffic objects to measurements of object merging and multipath propagation. Overall, we recorded more than 700 measurements with three different radars. This database was used by IPG to validate the new model. They rebuilt the test cases in CarMaker and compared the results to the measurements. There are two different approaches to simulate our radar. The first pipeline illustrates the real radar. The hardware layer contains the digital and analog front end for transmitting the electromagnetic waves. After reflecting at targets or the environment, they are received by the analog front end, which is followed by the digital front end. The last step of the hardware layer is the digital backend. All other steps are performed in software. In the low-level detection processing, a list of detections is extracted from the radar data cube. Afterwards, these detections get clustered and filtered. The final detection list is then fed to the component under test, for example, an object tracking algorithm. The second pipeline shows the faster simulation that takes the output of CarMaker in VRX mode, applies the beamforming and the sensor model ensures similarity of the final detection list between simulation and real data. In the last pipeline, we even go a step further. The simulated data from CarMaker is transferred to an adapter that allows to feed the data to our real radar. In that case, the pipeline from the digital backend up to the component under test is equal to the pipeline in the real radar. This approach is not real-time capable anymore, but simulates the radar on a very low level. Now I want to show you how CarMaker is integrated in our daily development process. First of all, our software component test is using the automotive data and time-triggered framework from Electrobit, also known as ADTF. In this framework, it does not matter if the radar data is coming from a test car, test bench, or the simulation with CarMaker. Single components can be tested independently or in combination. As long as no feature test is performed, like for ACC or AEB applications, the components are not changing the behavior of the car in the simulation. This allows to record and replace scenarios from the simulation, which is especially helpful when the simulation is not real-time capable. In our daily development process, we use Jenkins for continuous integration. The server is replaying measured and simulated data and creating test reports overnight. Every developer receives the result in the next morning after he applied changes to a software component. In the next slides, I want to show you some examples of these components. The software component, Ego Motion Estimation, calculates the velocity of the Ego vehicle based on the radar detections. It is using the static detections for that goal. The advantages of virtual validation are similar for all components. We can easily create special test cases that are difficult to test in a real system. For example, what happens if we are driving on the highway and there is a big truck in front of us and also two moving objects blocking most of the field of view on the right and left side? The number of static detections will be quite low. We can answer the question if the calculation of the ego velocity is still correct. The simulation data supports the developers during the whole development cycle. In the pictures, you can see how the car is driving on a curved road, and the graphs are showing the ground truth velocity based on CarMaker's inertial sensor in blue and the calculated velocity in red. Obviously, the calculation is following the ground truth values quite well. To verify if the test run is passed, we check if the difference between the ground truth and the calculated value is always within the thresholds defined by the requirements. An example from the test reports with X, Y, and Z velocity can be seen in the picture on the left side. The next example is the software component object tracking. It allows to detect traffic objects in the detections and tracks them by predicting their positions and velocities. For this component, we can also create corner cases easily that are difficult to test in the real world. Furthermore, reference sensors like differential GPS are required. In CarMaker, we can simply compare the output of the object tracking with the object sensor. Both are providing objects with position, velocity, and size. On the left side, you can see a test case where the ego car is entering the highway. The orange boxes on the black background are the tracked objects. They are based only on the detections of the radar raw signal interface. The last example is the free space estimation. It calculates the unblocked area around the ego car based on an occupancy grid map. Every detection from the radar is put inside this map. The component is using the ego velocity to compensate the own movement in this map. Afterwards, it is used to calculate vectors that describe the free space area around the car. The result will be compared to the output of the free space sensor in CarMaker. Similar to the object tracking, the simulation allows validation independent of complex reference sensors in the test cars. It can also provide special test cases where the free space is limited by walls. That way, the size of the area can be compared and also the vectors are accurately defined. CarMaker supports the developers through the entire development process of this component. Thank you for your attention. I hope you understood how CarMaker is used to validate the software components in our radar pipeline. Last but not least, I would like to thank IPG for the great cooperation to improve the radar simulation. It was a pleasure to be part of the development process for CarMaker 9.